or we head to water parks because we have a breakfast reservation at Chef Mickey's, which neither of us have ever done, so look forward to that. And then we are going to be heading over to Lizard Beach. Is that where we're going to? Yeah, yeah. Beach. So we're going to Lizard Beach today, and then tomorrow we're going to do Typhoon. So yeah, we're just going to head there. To get yours and wrapped it around.
Oh! Twirling, okay.
Oh, thank you!
You're not on video, are you?
I was. Just finished our breakfast at Chef Mickey's, which was really nice, and got to meet basically the Fab Five, so that was good fun. We are now just walking on the walkway to Magic Kingdom because we're going to get the buses to Lizard Beach because they don't do them from the Contemporary, so we're just heading there now. And I'll probably just switch over to my waterproof camera by that point because I think I'm going to put this away in my locker. So hopefully the next bit you see will be on the waterproof because that's will be at Lizard Beach. So we'll see you then. Hey guys, so I realised I never actually filled you guys in on what the plan then became. So the next bit of footage that you're gonna see is actually not from Lizard Beach, it's from Typhoon Lagoon. Basically, and I do explain this sort of later on in the video, but just for now, it was gonna take a really long time to actually get to Lizard Beach, and by this point we were already running quite late anyway because of having the breakfast, and we just wanted to spend as much time as we possibly could in the water parks, so we decided instead to go to Typhoon Lagoon, which is my favourite of the two water parks. I don't know about you guys, you can let me know in the comments below which one you prefer. But for me, it definitely is Typhoon Lagoon. I just love the theming. And so we decided to go there, which worked out really well because we ended up changing our plans for next week's video as well, just purely because of the time and the weather as well. That had a really big impact. So that is the footage that you're going to see next, not Blizzard Beach. So enjoy! Instead, we actually went to Typhoon Lagoon because we couldn't be bothered to wait for the bus to get to Lizard Beach because it ended up as needing to take like another bus to hop over, and by this point it was already like 11:30, so we just decided we'd go to Typhoon, so that's what we ended up doing, and that's all the footage you've just seen. We've now hopped over to Port Orleans so that we can get the bus to Hunter Studios because that's where we're heading to next. So this is just currently where we are. We just literally sat at the bus stop for Port Orleans, which is where my sister stayed last year actually. I don't know if I ever vlogged any of this, probably didn't. But yeah, this is where we are, so we're just gonna wait for the bus and then we are heading to Hollywood Studios.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, all people of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land, please welcome Her Majesty, the Queen of Arendelle.
Hello, citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land. I'm Anna. Oh, Princess Anna. And while you're all here to hear the story of my sister, the Queen of Arendelle, please help me welcome the newly appointed Royal Historian of Arendelle.
story of Anna and Elsa. We also invite you to join us in the singing of the anthems of Arendelle. If you don't know the words, just follow along.
I have a feeling they already know the words.
It was a beautiful day in the kingdom of Arendelle.
There were two sisters who loved each other very much.
Princess Anna and Princess Elsa.
Elsa was born with special powers.
Magical powers. She could create snow and ice, and Anna loved playing in her snow.
And then Elsa creates a snow monster!
You're getting ahead of yourself again. This is when Elsa hits Anna with her powers and freezes her head.
The king and queen rush Anna to the trolls.
Yes.
If you don't know what a troll is, consider yourself lucky. They are mischievous creatures with strange magic, and frankly, I never liked them. One of them stole my girlfriend in college.
Okay, focus.
Her hobby was a rolling stone.
That's enough. And then the saddest thing happened.
No more snowman?
No more snowman.
Get ready to sing.
Oh. Elsa? Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away.
She steals the crown.
Oh, did you sleep through all of Arendelle History 101?
Oh, yes.
It's Coronation Day. The window is open, so's that door. I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no ball?
Tall, dark, and dreamy. Oh, there he is right there. Prince Hans of the Southern Isles.
I don't like him. He's too good looking.
You're just jealous because he's dreamy.
You have said that already.
Oh, and I'm going to say it again. Because the dude is dreamy, am I right?
I am sweating.
And they danced the night away.
Yes, Hans. Not love. They had only just met.
Well, apparently you don't know much about love. I mean, come on. As a wise woman once said, love is an open door.
Stop watching, Oprah!
I will not!
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face, and then suddenly I bump into you.
I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you,
I find my
I see your face.
And
say something crazy?
Yes.
Yes, our queen froze our beautiful kingdom, sending it into a dark, cold girl.
It was beyond cold. It was frozen!
Well, Elsa couldn't come back. Now everyone knew of her icy power.
I see the problem. Snow untrusted her. Ooh, chill.
Well, our queen was alone, and she was lost. But for the first time in her life, she felt truly free.
This song is for you, Dad!
To receive a kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I've tried.
Marshmallow. Giant snowman, 10 feet tall.
20, 30. Kristoff and Anna almost died jumping off of the cliff. but there was snow there to break their fall.
Even that Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair starts to turn white, so Kristoff takes her to see the love expert.
Trolls!
Yep.
They try to marry Kristoff and Anna!
Even though she's still engaged to Hans of the Southern Rite.
Who she just met!
But that's okay, because everybody's a bit of a fixer-upper!
Woo-hoo!
It's too late, though. Anna's growing colder by the moment, and as Grandpappy said...
Only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
We gotta finish the story!
So they raced off to Arendelle to find Hans, so he can melt Anna's heart with true love's kiss. The true love!
Oh, while Prince Hans leads a group of men to capture Elsa! Not a cool move, Hans.
Well, Kristoff gets Anna to Hans, and he leads in to kiss her and save the day when...
He laughs! In her face!
What? Hans is the bad guy?
Oh, yeah, he's all... History 101? Yeah. No, she did.
Well, Elsa escaped the prison! And she's running across the fjord with Hans in hot pursuit, and Olaf goes to Anna's rescue.
Helping Anna realize that Kristoff, not Hans, is her true love!
Speaking of the pungent reindeer care, he is racing back across the fjord in the middle of Elsa's storm as it reaches fever pitch.
I think anyone had a fever in that blizzard.
Ba-da-ba!
Oh, yeah.
Now Anna's on the fjord and she's running towards Kristoff while she's shuffling. And she sees Hans. Kill her sister. Does she save herself? Does she save her sister? What to do?
I don't know!
I don't know either!
Olaf kisses Anna!
Really?
Oh yeah!
Alright!
The talking snowman is the act of true love that can thaw a frozen heart and everyone lives happily ever after! Because some people are worth melting for! The end! Thank you!
Sharing our story.
Oh, thank you.
And that was a very good story you told, though the ending felt a little strange. Well, Olaf did help a lot.
Anna, it was you who saved your sister and yourself.
An act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
For my sister, Elsa, I love you.
Straight to our first fast pass, which was the frozen summer fun thing, which I just showed you guys. Just had a quick bit of dinner, literally in and out, just quickly to go grab something, and we are now heading to our second fast pass of the day, which is Hollywood Tower of Terror. Purposely fast pass this because it freaks me out, even though I like the ride, and I didn't want to wait in an hour queue, so we're gonna go and do that now.
Star in its own right, a beacon for the show business at least. Now, something is about to happen that will change all that. The time is now, on an evening very much like the one we have just witnessed. Tonight's story on the Twilight Zone is somewhat unique and calls for a different kind of introduction. This, as you may recognize, is a maintenance service elevator, still in operation, waiting for you. We invite you, if you dare, to step aboard, because in tonight's episode, you are the star, and this elevator travels directly to the Twilight Zone.
Next, we see the Twilight Zone.
writing it down, and my GoPro thing is in my other bag, which I don't have on me right now. So we went to our Terra, as you guys saw a little bit of that, and then hopped straight over to Rockin Roller Coaster, which we got stuck in the queue for quite a while. We were supposed to be going to Fantasmic now, but that one's been cancelled because of the weather. So we're going to actually come here tomorrow, I think, and do that instead, and go to Animal Kingdom a bit earlier and not do the rest of the water parks. So we have a Fast Pass free now, so we're going to go do Toy Story Midway Mania, because we haven't done that one yet, and then just carry on going around the park, doing the bits we haven't done. And then watching the fireworks before we head back. So we're just heading to Toy Story now. Just to show you guys how much has been literally like closed off, this was like backlot tour here, and then behind that was like all the lights make to action and the Streets of America stuff, and I literally can't get past Toy Story. That's how closed off it is. So literally like the Bugs Life thing, which you can't see, but it's like over here, like the whole thing gone. Insane. We are heading into Star Tours. Da da da. Only a 10 minute wait and then we're gonna go and watch the fireworks.
Man, you droids on Transport 1401. Get back to work.
Now see what you've done. We'll lose our jobs for sure.
Passengers only.
Wow, there's something you don't see every day. Actually, I do. Every day.
Star Wars fans, so there weren't really any fireworks. It was all like a stage show on the Chinese theatre. And half the time I didn't know who the character was. I know who Darth Vader is, and that's about it.
I didn't really understand the storyline, as I'd never really seen the movie.
Yeah, we've not watched it, so it really wasn't that great. Yeah. Personally, for us, we wouldn't watch it again.
No.
Because there weren't very many fireworks, and last year, when there was actually the Star Wars weekend, those fireworks I actually thought were really good. But there just weren't very many fireworks
in this
show.
And they were very to the side, so it's like...
Yeah, and because they've closed all the park, or like the back end of the park, they couldn't put the fireworks where they normally would, so they were to the side. So even if you'd got onto like the main... street of Hollywood, you'd still have to look sideways, so it just didn't, for me, just didn't really work. I wasn't a huge fan of them personally.
No,
so that was our review. But if you like Star Wars, you probably will like it, because I think a lot of people are raving about it.
Yeah.
So there you go.